Hello listeners, I'm Rahul Sethi, your host for PayTech Bytes. Welcome to our podcast series where we will explore the world of digital payments, current trends and the ecosystem as a whole in a bite-sized episode. In this episode, we delve into an important topic of importance of compliance in the light of new license regime in the payment industry. And joining us today is Mr. Ramesh Narasimhan, Chief Executive Officer, Worldline India, who will share his insights on this topic. Welcome to PayTech Byte, Ramesh.
Thank you, Rahul. It's great to be here.
To start our discussion, can you briefly explain our listeners the current landscape of digital payment ecosystem in India from the compliance perspective?
Great question, Rahul. And if you look at the landscape, we now have a lot of regulation around the digital payments. We have a regulator who's extremely proactive, and you have the NPCI, the National Payments Corporation of India, and the government working extra hard to digitize payments in India. And we ourselves now have received the license for the PA license for continuing our business in Worldline e-payments. In addition, if you see, the RBI has now come out with guidelines, discussion guidelines on regulating the POS business as well and cross-border. So a lot of activity, you know, and it is also a result of the phenomenal success of digital payments. And don't forget that ultimately, the RBI wants to protect the end consumer, which is people like you and I in our real lives when we use digital payments. So that's the landscape of, you know, compliance in digital payments today.
Sure, got it. So why do you think, according to you, compliance is important? And can you share a few instances with our users to understand the same better?
So compliance is important for the simple reason is that we handle public money.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Right, and it's your money, my money, when we do digital transactions. And as an aggregator, you are essentially collecting these monies, pooling it, and then paying the merchants.
Yeah.
Right, after deducting some charges for yourself and the schemes and everybody else. Now, at a scale, if you see, payment companies like us are handling billions and billions of rupees, thousands of crores on a on a daily, weekly, monthly, annual basis. And all this money belongs to the public at large. So it needs to be clearly guarded, protected, and ensured that the right money reaches the right person.
Mm-hmm.
For example, if I buy something from a shop, then the money that I have transacted using my card has to be given to the shopkeeper for the goods that you have bought from the shopkeeper, right? So when you have public money at large being handled and more cases of digitalization of payments happening, the RBI currently has been handling it as per the 2007 Payments and Settlements Act.
Yeah.
Right. And what they're doing is more and more, if you see, to prevent frauds, to prevent money laundering, and to ensure that terrorist financing doesn't happen through these digital systems, the RBI is insisting on foolproof KYC, know your customer.
Yeah.
Right. Which every payments company has to do for every single merchant of theirs, a detailed KYC. They've spelled out more and more detail on KYC going forward. And this KYC is common across the entire, you know, financial systems landscape of India. Whether you're a bank or whether you're a, you know, payment aggregator, the KYC is common and it has to be done for every single merchant you onboard, right? To prevent these kind of events from happening. People, you know, trying to launder money through these systems. You have to prevent that, right, at the end of the day. So this is the reason why compliance is important. And as you see in a world where there are so many geopolitical tensions, as well as you see crooks trying to exploit the system, then as a regulator, they're also worried about the security infrastructure that each of these companies have, whether it be information technology infrastructure or security infrastructure, to prevent these kind of hacks or crooked people from getting into your system and you know, trying to divert your money or trojans or, you know, lock you out of your systems and, you know, essentially ransomware. So there's so many modus operandi they operate. So it is very important that we as a company are compliant from all aspects, not just from ensuring KYC is done, but whether it be our IT infrastructure, whether it be our security infrastructure, we have to ensure that all these are in great shape and follow processes that are laid down by us. Yeah. Right? I mean, it's very important that all our employees get into this culture of compliance, sure. which is to follow the process, right? And not deviate from the process. Because sure. moment you deviate, then you're questioning the process or you're putting the process at risk.
Yeah.
And that ensures that you're no longer compliant. And as you can see, penalties for non-compliance are very high.
Huge. Yeah.
If you see the way the RBI has clamped down on some fintechs, on a few banks, for reasons of IT infrastructure, for reasons of security, for reasons of not having adequate KYC, for not following essentially the rules as laid down by the regulator. These are all very, very important reasons to ensure that we comply.
As for the confidence of the ecosystem as
Absolutely.
Well. Yeah. So in closing, what are your final thoughts that you would like to share with our listeners?
So one, I want to put a macro thought. First is that, with this kind of regulatory focus, it basically is making the entire payment ecosystem more resilient, transparent, with robust regulations. And it ensures that people do not go lax on compliance while trying to grow their business. That arbitrage has ended now with everybody getting licensed or the right parties as the RBI feels after exhaustive investigation of your systems, your scrutiny of your processes and everything is when the RBI gives you a license, right? And so it kind of eliminates that arbitrage that some companies had saying, I'll take shortcuts here and grow my business. What the RBI is also trying to do is to ensure that serious players are there in this for the long term.
Yeah.
Not some, people who are there to make a quick buck or play the valuation game, right? So, these are essentially what the RBI would want is strong entities with proper capital backing, ability to sustain the capacity and business over the long time, well-defined governance and risk management. All this, by the way, we do. We do merchant risk, we do enterprise risk, we're doing compliance. We have everything that we've always looked at, and we've always been a company that's with an intent to comply.
Thanks, Ramesh. We appreciate your time and insights. And thank you for joining us on PayTech Bytes. Thank you for listening to this episode of PayTech Bytes. We hope you find the discussion insightful. Stay tuned for the next episode.
My pleasure.
Thank you.